I'm shaking, drinking all this coffee. These last few weeks have been exhausting.
If you were not Jeremy Zucker, would you be a fan of Jeremy Zucker?
That's a really interesting question. If I was not me, would I be a fan of me?
Yeah.
Yes, but I think I wouldn't be, or not that I wouldn't be a fan, but like I wouldn't be a fan of myself for my most popular songs, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
Because the ones that really speak to me just as a person are kind of my more like unknown songs.
Do we know what those songs are so we can stream it and try to
yes.
get in your headspace?
Yeah, yeah. One of my favorites is Don't Come Over, I'm an Asshole.
Don't come over, I'm not even dressed yet, had a 9 to 5.
From my first album, Orchid is a special one to me.
Okay.
From Crusher, No One Hates You Like I Do is a special one. Yeah.
All right.
Sleepers.
No, I love it. I think it's always like a interesting phenomenon to think about, like, would we listen to ourselves if we were not ourselves, right?
And sadly, there's no way to know.
Yeah. Well, like, when I told my friends that I was interviewing you today, you're all freaking out because like, I listen to his music when I'm sad, right? Like, whose music do you listen to when you're down?
Oh, when I'm down, I mean, my like original sad album is the self-titled album by Oh Wonder.
Okay. They're great.
That one, yeah, I love them so much. That one, when I was in university, like really got me through a lot. And for a while, it was like my napping album
mm-hmm.
because it was just like so calming and so relaxing. And I'd have 20 minutes in between classes to like take a nap. And so I would just play that album and like really be comforted and also fall asleep.
Mm-hmm. So we're gonna flip to now I'm So Happy.
Mm-hmm.
I'm so glad to know you. Won't be hit up with my mood.
I mean, I have to ask you, when was like the last time you felt like without a shadow of a doubt, like happy?
Fairly recently, I'd say on this tour. It's just been such an amazing experience to travel the world, especially, you know, after like COVID. I mean, it's still going on in a lot of places,
yeah.
but it's just been really great to travel and like meet fans and eat good food and
to finally do that, right? Because
yeah.
like, I bet when you were cooped up at home, that was like the image that you were
yeah.
working towards.
I mean, when the pandemic started, that's the thing that I was looking forward to the most.
Yeah.
And then I had no idea that I'd have to wait 2 years to go and do it again.
Yeah.
yeah.
God's grace, you're here. You know,
yeah.
You're doing it right now.
Yeah.
And in I'm So Happy, though, I think the brilliance of the song is because we're always constantly sort of sold what happiness is. Like you got to buy something or you need to obtain this or you got to be in a relationship to be happy. And then this is more of like an independent sense of happiness.
Mm-hmm.
Where does that stem from for you?
In the song, it's sort of about everything being perfect except one person is sort of ruining it for you.
Yeah.
The song is about this fantasy of instead of wishing somebody was somewhere with you, sort of fantasizing about them not being there.
Yeah.
In that situation,
yeah.
So it's like
instead of
I'm so happy you're here, it's like I'm so happy you're not here.
Yeah,
you know, and you're just like able to finally relax and chill.
What would you say to the person who has experienced a lot of their own life with your music? Your music plays a role in a breakup, in healing, in learning to stand up again. What would you say to that person who's been your music's been a soundtrack to their lives?
Wow. I think it's really special that you can connect with a song in that way. And it's pretty surreal thing for that to be my music. But I would just say I know the feeling and I'm happy that you found it.
Kiss 92.